Great to see you guys again.
Yes. Okay, so here I am with Carlos right there.
Hi.
And I do have a question about this one because it looks very, very interesting right here. So can you tell us all about this particular one?
Yeah, absolutely. So this is a brand new unregistered cross.
Okay.
And it's a cross between a Stanhopia by Acinita back to a Stanhopia Tigrina, which has a very dark color. Now the Stanhopia Tigrina has about 4 to 5 flowers per stem and really large flowers.
Okay.
While the Stanhopia by Acinita cross at the top has a high flower count, but the flowers are a little bit smaller. So by crossing the mother plant to the father down below, we're expecting very floriferous orchids with larger flowers that are really fragrant and very, very dark. So for right now, we actually have them in these little plastic pots and bar, but these will do very, very well in a basket with some moss.
Okay.
So when you repot this little guy, Maria, you're gonna put this in a basket with some moss, and the inflorescence is gonna come out of the bottom.
Yeah.
And it's gonna be so, so beautiful, and it's extremely fragrant.
Nice.
So yeah, that's gonna be this cross right here,
okay.
And it's never been done before, it's brand new, and I hope that you yield some really interesting results, and I can't wait to see
it
flowers for you.
So when you say this is brand new, this is practically rare then, because no one else has it.
That's
right.
First time that it's ever been done. Yeah.
Okay. So tell us more of what you have here.
Yeah, so this is all of our catasetums that we have left.
Okay.
And these ones are very tropical growers. They do fantastic out here in Florida.
Uh-huh.
You will see that many of them have gone into their dormancy period already.
Yeah.
And so they're not receiving any water whatsoever.
Okay.
Now, in the springtime, when you see a new growth developing, that's a sign that it's coming out of dormancy.
Uh-huh.
But you want to wait to water. You want to wait until the roots are approximately 4 to 8 inches in length. And then you can begin irrigating once more, at which point they get very big and they're very vigorous.
Yeah.
So that's these ones right here.
And some of these are fragrant too as well, right?
Oh yes, they're extremely fragrant. Now fragrance is a recessive trait, same thing with the cattleyas, but it's a recessive trait. So many of these will come out with fragrance and others might not,
okay.
But about 75% of these will have a beautiful fragrance.
Ooh, nice.
Yeah, and very showy flowers.
Yes.
So, all the
and
flowers.
Unique.
Exactly.
Yeah. Wowzer.
Mm-hmm. So all the flowers you see here are actually the male flowers, but these also have the opportunity to produce female flowers as well.
Okay.
But
and that's
yeah.
with all catasetum types?
That's with all catasetum
okay.
types. Now there are a few new iterations, I guess you could say some newer hybrids
yeah.
that have what we like to call the perfect flower.
Yeah.
So a lot of the Cycnodes actually have both male and female reproductive parts already in the flower,
uh-huh.
and that is what we consider the perfect flower.
Nice. You want to tell us about the cattleyas that you have here?
Yeah, so for the cattleyas that we have here, we have these 4-inch blooming cattleyas.
Okay.
These ones are about 4 years old, and then the smaller ones in the 3-inch pots, these are 3.5 years old.
Okay.
So they're already blooming size. Typically cattleyas don't bloom until they're 5 years old, so
uh-huh.
it's a very good sign of vigor to see them flowering this small.
Yeah.
Now over on this side, we actually have our unreleased cattleyas
oh.
for 2020. So all of these will be available in February, but we wanted to bring everyone here in Florida something special. So we decided to just bring all of our new 2020 crosses. Yeah, they're all brand new as well.
And like you said, these are not registered and they're not yet available to anyone because you
yes.
guys are the only ones that have hybridized them.
That's right. So for example, this one here is actually a cross between Plum Lulu by Ellen Condo. Now
okay.
this is the first bloom of this batch. So this one is barely turning 3 years old and it already flowered, as
wow.
you can see here.
Yeah.
So they have a very beautiful, rich colored flower and they're extremely fragrant. So
nice.
When that one grows up, you can expect it to be tall with a very beautiful bouquet,
wow.
beautiful head of flowers.
Yeah, mm-hmm. I see their color is very dramatic as well.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm also noting that even though it's solid in color. I'm noticing that there's a darker speckling that has potential of being in the petals as well, right?
That's right. So they're going to be spotted and very dark as well.
Wow.
So that's a very good observation, and I really love the spotted cattleya.
Yeah,
so
me too.
At the nursery, I got into some trouble because I got like 6 of them just for myself set aside, and oh, I can't wait for them to flower. I'm so excited.
Oh, yeah. Well, thank you so much for giving us a very in-depth, detailed description of each one.
You're very
really
welcome.
Really have learned so much from you today, Carlos. Thank you.
And thank you for stopping by. It's great to see you and your husband again. You guys are wonderful people, and I really hope that you enjoyed the festival.
Thank you, and we did. We enjoyed you as well.
You're making me blush.